Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do the daily vibes for around the 19th. Yeah, but we know the timing is fluid, right? And not every reading is for you, so this reading could happen at any time, all right? So we're just going to see what comes up. You want to check out your weekly reading is in a playlist. I've also done the February's if you want to check out your February reading. What do we have for a message today? Justice reversed. Right off the bat, January 19th or thereabouts, there's been some sort of dishonesty, right? There's been dishonesty. Somebody hasn't been telling truth. Lies. Lack of accountability. Somebody's been lying. They've broken the law. We have somebody here that has broken the law. No doubt. This is a legal loss, an injustice, an argument with no resolution in sight. And that is happening because somebody hasn't been telling the truth. King of Pentacles. So this is somebody that is very materialistic, very greedy. King of Pentacles is somebody that is very focused on financial gain. Ten of Cups. Page of Cups reversed. Ten of Cups is about, this is about happiness and fulfillment. That's what's coming. That's what's in the future. There is a spiritual blessing that is coming. But with the Page of Cups reversed, there's a lack of emotion. So we do have an individual that is very, very greedy that lacks emotion. There could be some bad news coming. There could be a legal loss here. This is bad news. I mean, the Page of Cups reversed is shattered dreams. This is a rejection of some sort. Right underneath the Justice reversed, there could definitely be a rejection. We have somebody that is very set in their ways, very, very stubborn, materialistic, very clever and very cunning, that is not emotionally centered. This person is not very fluid either. So we have somebody here that is extremely stubborn, extremely set in their ways, that is lacking emotion, that is not telling the truth. Maybe it has to do with a relationship, you know, or about their fulfillment or something like that. Somebody's not telling the truth. But happiness is coming because that is in the future. So there is some sort of happiness that is coming. Knight of Swords reversed. Now the Knight of Swords reversed, that is somebody, I feel like there's somebody that is looking for a fight. There's somebody that is looking for a fight that has been leading somebody, others into danger. This is somebody that is a blamer, somebody that is unable to master their emotions. I feel like we have a lawbreaker here. Somebody that is breaking the law, which is interesting. You know, or they're, you know, it could just be karmic law. You know, they're doing something that is against the universal law, or they're just doing something that is against the law. This is somebody who doesn't care who they hurt. The Knight of Swords reverse is somebody that is out of control. This is a clueless, ignorant know-it-all that is looking for a fight and doesn't care about the law. All they care about is holding on to their position. The King of Pentacles is about position. I want to hold on to my position. So we have somebody here that wants to hold on to their position. It's not about the feelings. It's about holding on to the relationship or holding on to the fulfillment, you know. Somebody wants to hold on to something. They're not ready to let it go. This Knight of Swords reversed. That is insincerity, explosive behaviors, blaming others for what they have done. I feel like you do have somebody that is blaming others for what they have done. King of Swords reversed. A lot of dishonesty. We have an untrustworthy individual here. There's no doubt about it. This is somebody who may proclaim their love, or they may proclaim their, you know, that they're a happy person, or that they're in a happy relationship, or that they're stable, solid, secure, but they're not. This is somebody that is untrustworthy. So we definitely have an untrustworthy individual here. It's like we have a bully. There's unfair treatment, no doubt about it. So yeah, we have some unfair treatment. King of Swords reversed, Knight of Swords reversed, dishonesty, lack of truth, challenging information is coming. There is going to be some challenging information that is about to come out. We have a very cold, hard, uncaring individual that is probably mentally challenged. You know, they may have some sort of, well, they're definitely cold, very, very, very cold, cold-hearted. We definitely have a cold-hearted individual here that is very focused on, you know, financial gain, you know. Anyhow, Knight of Swords reverse. This is reckless behavior. It is. Doesn't care. Totally non-caring. Doesn't care about a relationship. Something that Ten of Cups is about relationship. But this could be the end of a relationship because tens are completions. But there is going to be some sort of alignment. I believe there's going to be an alignment with the Ten of Cups. There's an injustice, there's unfair treatment, lack of accountability. Somebody's definitely been lying. Lying about a relationship or something about that. Five of Swords reversed. We have mentally dysfunctional here as well. There's somebody here that is mentally dysfunctional. Just saying. This is somebody, there's a bully. They are abusive. You have an abusive character in this reading. This person does not care who they are. At all. As long as they win. We got somebody here that wants to win at all cost. I feel like there could be some crime that is exposed. Or there is some sort of revenge that is about to play out. This is like a volatile situation. It could be war with the Five of Swords reversed. This could be all out war. It could be, and the same with the Knight of Swords. This is like waging war of some sort. A fight. We definitely have a fight here. There's lack of accountability. Somebody, there's been an injustice. There's something that is unbalanced. There's a lack of truth, and there really is a lack of truth here. Lack of truth, lack of truth, lack of truth. So somebody has really, really been lying. And I feel like there's going to be some exposure of some sort. Exposure of the truth. It has to do with a relationship because of that Ten of Cups underneath. Somebody's bubble is about to be burst. And it has to do, there's a relationship here where somebody really, there's going to be a rejection of some sort. There's going to be some sort of rejection or consequences even. These lies are, because this is lies, and this is some sort of exposure. And I feel like there's going to be a huge battle with the Five of Swords reverse. This is like all out war. There could be some arrest. There could be some humiliation that is happening. We got somebody here that just wants to be right. This is a huge power struggle. Somebody that wants to prove something, and they're going to, and they're doing it in a manner that is dangerous. It looks like this is a dangerous situation. Six of Swords. Now, the Six of Swords is about moving to a better place, moving on, taking a new approach. Now, we have somebody here that is floating away, you know, is saying goodbye. The Six of Swords is leaving. Look at all the swords in the water. I never noticed that with this card. There's only three swords. Well, there's two over here. Anyway, so that we do have a painful experience that is happening, and somebody is going away. somebody is definitely going away. And it's sad. It's very, very sad. So this is some sort of departure. This is a departure. Six of Swords. Somebody is leaving. It's sad. We have somebody here that is angry and upset, but they can't, you know, they may be feeling it a lot, but they're holding it in. They're holding their feelings in. This is somebody that is very cold and will never show their feelings. So somebody is holding their feelings in. Very, very cold. But this is feeling extremely defeated. So this is a defeated energy. It's time to go. It's time to move on. Four of Wands reversed. This is party is over, right? This is the end of a celebration. It is. This is unhappy about moving on. You know, I feel like we have a commitment here. If somebody was committed to something, it may not be working out. There's some sort of abuse, bullying, lies, dishonesty. Four of Wands reversed. This is lack of happiness, lack of growth, a separation of some sort. There could be a change in the home because fours are about foundations and this is about a foundation. This could be the end of a relationship, a change on the home front. Four of Wands reversed. This is nothing to celebrate. This is a messy situation. It is very, very messy. This party is over. The time is up. Yeah, it was fun, but it's over. It's over. We definitely have an argument, and it is a big one. It really is. With the Five of Swords and the Justice reverse, and this uncaring, cold-hearted individual that doesn't care who they hurt, that wants to win at all costs, that is very extremely stubborn and is lacking emotion, I feel like there's going to be a fight with whoever this person is. And it's time to go. Or let this other person go. It's like letting them go. It hurts. Just go. Just go. So yeah, I do feel like there's going to be some sort of departure here. Going to a better place. The Six of Swords is a time of transition. So yeah, we do have a transitional period here. Change in residence, perhaps, for some. We have a commitment that is definitely on the rocks, okay, because of that Four of Wands reverse. This is not not good news, okay? It's not good news with the Page of Cups reversed either. So I do feel like there's some sort of insincerity here. There's unrequited love or something like that. Somebody hasn't been treated fairly. There's a lack of equality. There's a lack of balance. There's been a lot of dishonesty. There's probably been a lot of bullying, mental abuse, verbal abuse, physical abuse, whatever. There's definitely been some abuse, and it's definitely time to move on. So somebody is going to be going somewhere with that Six of Swords. They are going to be going somewhere, or they're going to be letting another person go, okay? Could go either way. What is this Four of Wands reversed? Lack of contentment. Not happy. Not happy with this departure. Which could be a war. Because this is not happy with the departure. And here's the power struggle, the fight, the war. So, I mean, I don't know what's going on, but don't look good. Anyhow, we do definitely have a departure here. Seven of Cups. Now, the Seven of Cups is illusion. It's illusion. It's options. It's choices. It's confusion as well. Beware of false beginnings. We have somebody here that is not seeing clearly. They're not seeing clearly. They definitely can't see the truth. We have somebody here. And it could be a whole party. Huh? Oh, boy. That is not seeing the truth. Because this is a party. But the party is over. The party is over. Okay. Somebody is definitely in some sort of illusionary state of mind. They're not seeing the truth. There's a lot of other options here. There's a lot of illusion. There's a lot of fantasy. And there's a lot of confusion. So yeah, the Seven of Cups, there's options, there's choices, there's confusion. Delusional. There's delusion here. There is definitely delusion. We have a very clever individual who has planned something very, very well, because the King of Pentacles is a planner. That is a planner. So we have somebody here that has planned something very, very, very well. But whatever they've planned, it's all a lie. It's all a lie. It's all an injustice. It's all not real. Okay? There's a lot of lies here. There's a lot of lies here. And I feel like it's all an illusion. And I feel like there's criminal behavior. I do feel like there's criminal behavior. And I feel like it's been hidden. And I think it's been hidden from some sort of, you know, relationship. You know, because the Ten of Cups is a relationship, but it's the end. With the Ten of Cups, with the Four of Wands, this is the end of a relationship. So we do have a relationship that is ending. Somebody is going someplace. And I feel like it's because there's some sort of argument that happens, or some sort of can't win, because of that Five of Swords reversed. Can't win, defeated, it's time to go, it's time to walk away. So it's time to walk away. Eight of Cups reverse. Now the Eight of Cups reverse is pretending to be happy. And that's what I saw with the Ten of Cups too. It's like, this isn't real. This isn't real happiness. This is superficial. It's shallow. It's staying put. Somebody may be staying put as well with the Eight of Cups, not going somewhere, refusing to move on. But with the Six of Swords upright, that is moving on. So we definitely have opposition here. We have some sort of opposition. Again, with the Five of Swords, we have opposition. So you have somebody here that has been pretending to be happy. They've been pretending. They're superficial. They're shallow. There's a lack of spiritual growth. There's emotional weakness. This is staying in a situation that is emotionally unfulfilling because, you know, I don't know why. Staying in a position that is emotionally unfulfilling, that is not happiness, because of illusion, because of fantasy, because of, you know, I mean, the Seven of Cups is about too much. This is just too much. Could be overwhelming. Too many choices, too many options, not sure what to do, unsure. Somebody has been unsure, but it definitely is time to move on. Staying put in this disappointing situation is just prolonging the grief, right? Anyhow, Four of Wands, this is like thinking about walking away. Somebody's been thinking about walking away for quite some time, but they have been unable to do so because they are emotionally weak. And they've been in some sort of illusionary state of mind. And they've shut down their emotions. Somebody has totally shut down their emotions. They have. It's like totally shut down. With the Knight of Swords reversed, the King of Swords reversed, the Page of Cups reversed, this is total emotional shutdown. It is. Refusing to move on, but it is time to move on. It's time to open your eyes and choose another option. There's an opportunity for happiness here, but all you have to do is move on. But there's a lack of acceptance of the truth. So we have somebody here that is delusional and in fantasy land that is refusing to accept the truth because maybe they're financially stable. You know, or they just want to hold on to some their status or their position. You know, this is financially stable. It's stable. It's safe. It's solid. It's secure. So somebody's holding on to a position because it's, you know, it's a position of authority by the looks of things. Somebody's in an authoritative position, but there's no love there. That's for goddamn sure. Anyhow, excuse my language. There's no love in this situation. There isn't. There may have been at one time. But it's pretending to be in a happy relationship, because this is pretending, this is a happy relationship, but it didn't look like a happy relationship to me at all. And that's why I was so confused, and there's a lot of confusion here. So somebody is really confused. They're not in a happy relationship, but it looks good, right? It looks really, 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 really good to the outside world. Anyhow, With that justice reverse, there could be a loss here. There's an injustice. There's somebody's not going to be happy with an outcome. They're placing blame. There could be a fight. There's an argument with no resolution, right? There's a lack of accountability. There's dishonesty. There's an imbalance. It's time to move on. It is really, really, really time to move on. So I feel like on this day, there could be some tears. There could be a rejection. There could be some, a big, huge battle or a big, huge fight that pushes somebody away. And that is what I got. There's also going to be messages back and forth because the Eight of Wands is news arriving very, very quickly. Fast moving energy. Are you ready? There's going to be movement. It's going to happen very, very fast when you get the Eight of Wands. Fast forward movement. This is like travel, change, and movement. Eights are about change. So get prepared for a change. Things are going to change really, really fast from here on out. Good luck.